Yeah. In my white tee. Yeah. Call up Ike Williams for the hype, please. They gon' wipe you before you wipe me. Unboxes of checks, not my Nikes. Cactus, not no iced tea. Got them bamboozled like I'm Spike Lee. You need more than Google just to find me. I just call a beta, get a hyphy.
Incredible, general.
I just start the label just to sign me. Me and Chase connected like we Siamese. Been on a run, feel like a crime spree. Talk to me nicely. Yeah, I seen his face. Yeah, on his white tee.
Let's go. Yeah, call the Sprite people. Call them, hold on. Private flight franchise sites. On a private flight. Popped him in his hands, he was typing.
Caterpillar ride me, I fought to lift it up. I went on the stand, told the judge.
What's up, Cardinals? Dylan here with your daily announcements. Our boys basketball team hits the road tonight, hoping to finish a strong week. Tonight's opponent is the Champlain Park Rebels. There is no streaming available, so get to Champlain Park in person if you hope to see the boys in action tonight. Are you interested in a spring sport? Signups will only open on February 1st online through AH Connect. In order to participate, you must have a current sports physical on file with an activities office. And you must be completely signed up for the sport online. Spring sports that you can sign up for are baseball, softball, track and field, boys tennis, golf, and lacrosse. If you have any questions, please go see Miss Lacey in the main office. The free community movies at Kerwitz High School Auditorium this month are on Friday, January 14th at 7 p.m. The movie will be Disney's Encanto, and Monday, January 17th at 3 p.m., where the movie will be Selma. Enter door number 1 or 16. Concessions will be sold. Cash only, please. Save the date. There is a PSEO informational meeting February 3rd during early release. All students interested in participating in the PSEO next year must attend the PSEO meeting during early release on Thursday, February 3rd at 1:40 p.m. in the auditorium. Family members are welcome to attend. We'll cover info on PSEO, how to apply, and details how PSEO relates to high school graduation. An Anoka Ramsey Community College representative will be presenting about PSEO from the perspective of the colleges. Today's lunch will be chicken and maple waffle sliders. That's a few daily announcements. Have a good rest of your day, Cardinals.
Plant your flag and take a look around, because it's time to celebrate Coon Rapids Athletics. From swimming to basketball, we'll bring you all the best highlights. Sports Night is next.
Boys basketball team has been downright hot this season. A great start, and last week they started the new year with an 81-72 win over Cambridge Isani on the road. McKeith Deng, 24 points and 10 rebounds to lead the way in both categories. MJ Galima also added 20 points. Kaijon Cummings Coleman, or has he maybe come to known C-squared.
C-squared.
16 points, 9 steals. Elijah Smith, 10 points, 5 boards. And Matthew Ellingson had 6 points and 3 blocks.
Yeah, that was a big win for him on the road. So, well, the table was set perfectly for the Cardinals going to Thursday's home game against Maple Grove. The Cardinals hadn't beaten the Crimson in more than 15 years, but with the Crimson off to a slow start and missing some top players, it was an awesome opportunity to end a long drought against a conference power. Coon Rapids setting the tempo early. Kaijon Cummings Coleman shakes the defender to the floor and scores easily. Cardinals all smiles to start against Maple Grove. Their defense helped them build a lead. McKeith Deng with a couple of huge blocks against the Crimson. He also had 15 points. Cardinals led almost the entire game, but struggled with foul trouble. MJ Galima making the most of his minutes. That fadeaway part of team-high 17 points. Coon Rapids had a 15-point lead, trimmed to 2 points in the first half. They built it back up in the second. Peyton Himley's three-pointer helps them to a 60-44 lead with 10 minutes remaining. But it wasn't enough. The Crimson turned the tide down the stretch. Matthew Hossman, a couple of threes. to help them tie it up and force overtime. He wasn't done. Hausman hits a three from the left corner to tie the game at 75 with 90 seconds remaining in the extra period. 30 seconds left, the Crimson down one. They find Henry staying with an open jump shot, their first lead since early in the first half, and it holds. Crimson with a 79-76 win. I'm still fretting at that game.
It was a tough one to take, and really thought we were going to see them break a streak of 15 years estimated since they have beaten Maple Grove. This was the year this is the team that should have been
absolutely
able to do it, and just not able to close it out down the stretch. This team is essentially 2 to 3 points away from being 8-1 at this point in the season.
Yeah, I'm sure Coach Gork knows that, obviously, and I'm sure that, you know, as he posted on Facebook, or the basketball site posted, it was a gut punch for this team, and I think it really was, because they felt, you know, especially they're up by 16, they felt they had that opportunity to win, and quite obviously they should have.
Well, we will see if they will be able to bounce back. They host Spring Lake Park on Tuesday, and Howie,
we'll be there.
Hello, everyone, and welcome to the Roger E. Carlson Fieldhouse for CTN's live coverage of boys high school basketball. Another Northwest Suburban Conference showdown as the Cardinals host the Spring Lake Park Panthers. Ellingson back up top, Smith for three, it's good.
Yeah, nice job, and Elijah Smith, you know, he was a little quiet against Maple Grove, but he has that ability to step back and hit the three. And
Thompson high on the left side, draws the double team coming, pickpocketed by Cummings. Coleman at the other end, he scores.
And that, you know, that's one of the things that Coach Guzzi is going to take a timeout now. His team trailing 13-10.
Left side three-pointer is good for MJ Calama.
Well, you talk about when he starts to feel it and get in a rhythm, he's tough to stop.
Jump shot won't fall. The rebound by Leifker, then ripped away by Cummings Coleman. Ellingson behind the defense, the two-handed jam.
Yeah, Logan Kinsey thought better of it. He thought for a second he was going to try and get a block, but Ellingson had a step on him, and he didn't want to pick up. He's got a foul already. He didn't want to pick up his second.
Cummings Coleman jumps the pass, drives, scores, plus the foul.
He stole.
Thompson turns and shoots and hits for three. It's a one-point game. Wire tried to drop it off, but miscommunication leads to a breakaway and a dunk for Elijah Smith. Back the other way, trailed by Kinsey. Smith for three, it's good.
Nothing but that. That's a huge, huge three-pointer to push the lead to six. The Cardinals can just hold it up.
Smith wants another one, and he's got it.
That's huge.
He's got 18 points all of a sudden. Smith will just dribble out the clock. Cardinals get their first win over the Spring Lake Park Panthers.
That's a nice win.
The Panthers came into the conference in 2014.
Yeah, that's a quality win for this program.